As a UX or product designer, there's a really good chance that you have probably made a survey before. Sometimes survey tools can get in the way of us asking questions in the format or the style we want to. Other times, the survey simply doesn't look inviting or is legitimately hard to use. I myself have tried several different tools in search of the best experience for the design tool survey. It's a survey we run once per year and usually get about 4,000 to 5,000 responses. It involves several dozen questions and includes logic to conditionally show and hide certain sections for the respondents. If you're like me and still hunting for a great survey tool, I have just the tool for you. Tally is one of the easiest and most flexible form and survey builders that I've found. Tally is for you if you want to make an email list, create a sign-up form, gather user feedback, create in-product surveys, or anything you can think of involving forms. Today, I want to give you a run-through of Tally so you can decide if it fits in your design tool stack. And if you're wondering, Tally was not involved in the creation of this video, it's all me. So today we're going to create our own basic design tool survey in Tally and then explore how we can publish or embed it to start gathering responses. The first thing we'll do is start here on the Tally dashboard. So let's create a new form. And as we're creating one, you can see all of the different templates that give you an idea of the cool stuff you can make. We've got surveys, product questionnaires, wedding invitation forms, but let's go ahead and start from scratch. We'll call ours Little Design Tool Survey, because we'll mimic the pattern I use for the annual design tool survey, but just Lil. Tally lets us know that we can start building using the slash command, which is exactly what we're going to do. If you've ever used Notion, you're going to feel right at home here. The interface has taken a lot of inspiration from the way you build pages and blocks in Notion. We can add simple headings, we can add text and questions. There are all different types of questions and input forms. Many times I create a rough draft of my survey outside of the tool, usually in collaboration with a product manager or another stakeholder. I actually even recommend starting your survey on pen and paper or a whiteboard to help you think outside the tool. Ignore the constraint of digital experiences and instead focus on how to ask the right question. So in this case, if my survey is already written somewhere else, bulk insert saves me a lot of time. I can just paste the list right here inside the answer box, or I can use this context menu and select bulk insert. You'll notice our survey just got pretty long, and we don't necessarily want our respondents to have to scroll through a really long page. When we're ready to break things up, we can just use slash page, which automatically creates a section break. One of the things I love about this is how much control I have over creating my form or survey. I can even create multiple columns if I wanted to ask something like first name and last name. As I've created the design tool survey each year, I've tested out several different tools, and I've always had trouble managing the logic in the way I want. Tally makes this really simple. I just type slash logic and drop in a logic block. For example, let's only show this question about tools if someone indicates that they use this type of tool. So I'll create a new question asking if they used this type of tool. Then in my logic block, I'll select when, and I'll select the question we just made, then is, and then choose show blocks. Now we'll need to set our initial question blocks to hidden so they don't show up automatically. So let's check out the preview. When I select yes or no, the question appears and disappears. Nice. If I need to, I can create more complex rules using the or and operators. One way I'm using this in the actual survey is to detect if someone says yes to creating user interfaces, but no to conducting user tests. I pop up a question asking why they don't do user tests. Maybe they don't have a budget or they have a dedicated research team that does that. I like that I'm able to ask these questions only when they're applicable to the current respondent. Another way to make your form more intelligent is to use answer piping. This takes an answer from a previous question and inserts it anywhere in the form. This can be really helpful if you've shifted context in the survey, but you need to circle back to a question that the respondent may not remember their answer to. So let's ask a simple follow-up question about the cost of someone's primary tool. As we type in this question, I can use the at symbol to reference the answer from another question. Let's select our previous question. Now, this answer appears at the title of the question to help the respondent remember what they previously selected. With calculated fields, we can make our form even more intelligent. We can capture the value of a field or input and then use logic to manipulate it. Let's use another really basic example to see this in action. Since we're already asking how much this tool costs per month, we're going to generate a calculated field called cost and set it equal to the response of our previous question. Then we'll create a new logic block and multiply that by 12 to get the annual cost of the tool. Now, when I use the variable at cost, I'll be able to easily reference the annual tool budget of this respondent and maybe show or hide some questions depending on their budget. So those are some of the basics of survey creation in Tally. If this seems too simplistic, I can confirm that it can handle quite a bit more complexity. Here's a preview of what I'm working on for the 2022 design tool survey. I've noticed some actions have slowed down a little bit, but nothing that prevents me from getting my work done. Now that we've got a basic structure in place, we can look at different ways to style and publish the form. There are several basic design elements I can add here. An optional logo, a cover image or background color. Then, using the designed sidebar, I can change several colors and styles. And if you're feeling brave, throw in some custom CSS. The Tally team has provided the main CSS classes you need to control the form, which is really nice. Even if you don't feel comfortable here, you could collaborate with a developer or an engineer on your team. They probably won't have any troubles getting up and running here, seeing as it's pretty straightforward. And now we've created this beautiful form that any designer should feel proud of. And we're ready to share it with the world. We can preview and test it out at any time, just hitting the preview button. Once we've published our form, we have a few different options. First, we can just send a basic link, like if you were going to drop it in an email. We can also embed the form into a page, or this one's pretty interesting, we can embed the form as a pop-up on the page. I'm a big fan of surveying people during or directly after specific experiences so they have everything fresh in their mind. Tally makes this really easy to do. So Tally gives me some very basic code I can copy. I just paste this HTML into this script in my website or app. Then I can set that to automatically pop up or a button that will launch the pop-up. If you want to see this in action, I actually already have one of these up and running on the Design Tools database so people can suggest changes. It just pops up down here in the bottom right corner. If you even want to take it a step further, you can use Tally with a custom domain. If your website is already hosted on your domain, you can easily set it up with a subdomain as well. So you could do something like feedback.website.com or something like that. Once you start gathering responses, if you just need them in a tabular or CSV type format, then you're already good to go. However, Tally can pipe data into some of your favorite apps for further analysis and prioritization. There's a lot of cool things you can do here. For example, I'm routing the suggestions from the Design Tools database into a Notion database, so I can edit and prioritize them there. You could also add to a document, post in Slack, send a text, create a calendar event, and many other scenarios made possible here through integrations. I'm happy to report you can get really far on the free tier of Tally. Honestly, even the paid plan is significantly cheaper than many of the other survey platforms I've used. Tally also has a cool public roadmap so that you can see everything that they're working on and potentially when that might be coming out. Tally makes it really easy to create custom, flexible forms and surveys. I hadn't found this kind of flexibility in a survey tool before, and so I found it really refreshing to be able to build and drag and drop surveys like this, and I hope you do too. Take a look and let me know what you think in the comments.